Physics students looking for a STEM project may find this experiment simple enough to replicate. The experiment may be used as part of their introduction to quantum wave mechanics project. Professionals also might want to replicate it in their labs. Materials that are applicable to the process are relatively inexpensive and easy to attain.
Compression or tensile testing equipment with digital or data chart recorders are commonly found and used in mechanical testing labs. Our experiment produces a visual representation of the probability amplitude for various energy levels. In quantum mechanics, superposition particles in a 2D box.
The math formulas for the probability amplitude is described as the absolute value of the wave function squared. The visual solution we are usually shown looks like it is using Euler's contained column fixed method in our experiment. This is where the bounded ends of the column are not free to pivot. This experiment is a tactical strategy to test areas of a quantum jump that were not accessible without complex equipment.
Our experiment is an unstudied variation where the containing members move inward to compress the pre-buckled member. The first load-up begins with a downward force from the press onto the top of the preset curve. The force starts changing the bell-shaped curve to a square or U-shaped waveform. At the peak load for each phase change, the short straight sections of the U-shaped curve buckles. Only the minor bending resistance and some friction is left to resist the descending compression from the top plate of the press. The geometry of the system instantly reconfigures to a new wave frequency as it snaps down to the new stable zone. This new geometric shape formed at this energy level or phase is relatively neutral. The fast snap through to this energy level's being inherent to the process is synonymous with what is referred to as quantum jumps. This exponential increases in load to change the geometry of the material is coupled with the near total loss of resistance is the reason for the extremely fast jumps. The load graph shows the force required produces the next phase change or quantum jumps. The process requires an exponential increase in the peak load from the previous peak load level. In our experiment, the moving plate applies a compressive force onto the sinusoidal curves. The curves respond geometrically by forming AU or a square shape waveform. Joseph Fourier's studies on wave transformation and manipulation can show us how square waves can be produced. One of his transforms shows how using the sum of numerous overlapping waves of various frequencies produces a square shape wave. Is this equivalent to factoring all wave functions together to generate the next most probable wave function? The area under the curve changes as the load and